Hey guys, it's Jessica from Peace Love Books, and today I'm here with a new reading vlog that I think is gonna go by really fast because, one, I'm super excited for these books, and they're actually shorter than I thought they were. So I am reading Riley's Favorite Romances, Riley from Riley Marie. I feel like if you watch my channel, you watch her, or if you watch her channel, you watch me. I love Riley so much. I feel like I've known her for years, and we're friends, and I love her channel. I literally watch every single one of her videos. She is a romance booktuber, but she also reads a lot of thrillers, and she likes to read like darker things. I don't even know how to describe her taste because she reads so much. She likes to read some like sci-fi sometimes. I feel like she doesn't read too much fantasy, and if she does, it's fantasy romance, but I love her taste in romance, and she makes me want to read like all these other genres, and so I love her channel so much. I love her as a person, so of course I had to do her for reading a booktuber's favorite romances. And so the first one I have, though, is one that I don't know if it counts as a romance. I'm already halfway through it. Also, I started it this morning, but before I get to that, I did look at a bunch of her videos of her favorites, and I feel like it was either her favorites of 2020 or her favorites so far of 2020 for last year. I had literally read every single book in that video. We have such similar taste. I read so many books that she reads, and so I'm so excited for these because these are all books I already own. Like, they're books that I've seen that I really wanted to read. One of them I bought because of her, and the other two I bought because I've heard just amazing things in general about them, and I've read the authors. So the first one's A Dowry of Blood, and I've actually been seeing this a lot on Instagram lately. A few of my friends have been reading it, and it reminded me that I had to read it, and I was like, just do Riley's video now. I've already started the audio. It's really short, and I'm actually happy I read the audio because I noticed, like, if you can see, the chapters don't have chapter headings. It's just, like, starts a new section, and I don't know why, but that really bothers me. So the audio is really good, and especially because this, I don't know, is it Dracula? It is Dracula. Okay, so it's a lyrical and dreamy reimagining of Dracula's brides. I don't think she calls him Dracula. She's a vampire, and she is married, I guess, to this vampire who had turned her. So it starts out when we like see her being turned and like getting revenge on the people who tore up her town or something, and then she goes and lives with this vampire who's apparently Dracula. I don't know anything about Dracula. I haven't read Dracula. I don't think I've seen any Dracula movies. I don't know if he like has brides in the classic Dracula, but she's his bride, and they live like hundreds of years together, and then they have another bride. And it's interesting because it's told in second person, so she is basically telling the story to Dracula, and I feel like that's kind of taking me out of the story a little bit because I feel like I'm not as immersed and engaged into it because I just feel like she's telling me a story instead of I'm reading someone's life and their story, if that makes sense. I don't know if I'm making sense, but I just feel like she's just like kind of glossing over a lot because it's so short. Like, we've already gone through hundreds of years. It's actually over 200 pages, which I feel like it feels shorter than that. The audiobook's only 5 hours, and a lot of years have passed already, and a lot's already happened, and I'm only 3 hours into it. So I'm very, very intrigued by this relationship, though, especially because now there's another wife involved, and it's weird because he, like, calls them sisters, but she's actually falling for this wife too. So it's not just like she has to share Dracula with this other woman, but that she is fighting now that she might be in love with her too, and she's definitely not supposed to. Like, Dracula kind of encourages like a relationship between them, but she's not really supposed to want that, I guess. But it's so interesting so far, but I don't know if I love the perspective and the writing style, but it does make it feel more atmospheric, like, oh, this is my tale to tell, and I need to say something about it, and especially because it's written to him in second person. I think that's super interesting. It's just, like, not as engaging to me as if it weren't in second person, but I'm still super intrigued, and I'm really enjoying it. I don't know if I would say this is a romance. I'm interested to see, like, if she ends up with anybody in the end and like what the end game is, but she just figured out a secret about Dracula too, and he's very manipulative and controlling, so it's very interesting. So I'm really enjoying this, and today that I'm filming this is Halloween, so I feel like it's the perfect book to listen to. The next one, I'm so excited because I've read the other book in the series, and I don't remember what's 1, 2, or 3. I feel like this one's book 1. I could be wrong, but I've already read Haven, and this one is Harbor by Rebecca Weatherspoon, and in this one, it sounds so good. So I feel like she's engaged to, yes, so her fiance is killed. I guess he was found dead with his lover, and so the heroine ends up getting together with the other woman's boyfriend. Oh, okay, so I'm getting confused. So this is actually, I think, polyamorous. So we have Vaughn and Chris, and they lost the love of their lives, who was found in bed with Brooklyn's fiance. So I think they end up starting up a relationship with Brooklyn. So we'll see how it is. I know that Riley loves this, and I'm excited to read another Rebecca Weatherspoon book. But then I had to do Riley's favorite trope, which is ex-boyfriend's dad. So in this one, I'm pretty sure she was dating, I don't think she was engaged to him, but he's a doctor. Yeah, so her ex-boyfriend's father. And this one's really short too. It's not even 300 pages, but I am obsessed with the pool boy, so I have to read the doctor. I remember seeing them in the pool boy as characters, so I'm excited to see them. And so I am really excited. Such different books, but all have the tropes that I know Riley absolutely loves. So I can't wait to start these and see if I enjoy them. So I'll update you guys definitely when I'm done with this, which might be today. We'll see.
Hello everybody, I'm actually here with Miss Lily right here, Miss Darcy right here. We're probably gonna go upstairs soon, but it is actually still Halloween night, and I finished A Dowry of Blood. I actually finished this like before lunchtime. It read so fast. The audiobook was only like 5 hours, and I was doing a lot around the house and finishing up some sewing stuff. So I finished the entire thing, and I was able to include it in my October wrap-up. So if you've watched that, if you watched the very end, you might have seen my thoughts already. And I'm giving it 4 stars. It's not a romance, but I'm still gonna count it for this video because I know Riley loves it. And I can see why people love it, and I see what it's doing, because she never gives the man a name, or he really like entices them and captures, sorry, Lily's trying to lick my hand. He really like draws them in to this like family they have together, and he is very manipulative and abusive and traps them with him and then plays mind games with them, and he has a lot hidden of his own secrets that our main character slowly unravels, and there ends up being 2 more people added into their little family of like marriage kind of thing, and it like really pleases him to go out and be like, well, this is my wife and this is my niece or my orphan, or like new like names for that girl that they have with them, and then the guy too. And he's just like really bad, and so it's really about them surviving together and figuring out secrets that he has, and it was really interesting. I just like I said, I think the writing style kind of pulled me out a little bit, since it was her letter to him, and so I just felt like I was being told a story. I didn't feel like I was reading and immersed in the story. I was just being told it, and so it did skip a lot of time as well, and I would have liked a little bit longer time and more time spent there, so that's why it's 4 out of 5 stars. But it was very interesting. I don't think I would have picked it up without seeing Riley loving it, so I'm glad that I picked it up. But I do have Harbor, which is behind me. I do have to read Picture During Gray for school. We are almost done, but I always read with the kids, so we're at chapters 19 and 20, and then tomorrow night's 21 and 22, and we'll be done. But I have to read that first, and then I'll start that book. I did watch the first episode of Squid Games, and it was very interesting. So I already know the premise of Squid Games, and it was really slow in the beginning, though. I was like, when are we gonna get to like this whole game thing? And we finally got there at the end, so I'm very intrigued to continue on to the second episode. But I know it's beat out Bridgerton in the record that it holds on Netflix, which is fine, but I was very intrigued by it. So I'm very interested in like the commentary on how much crippling debt people will get into and what they will do to get out of debt and how desperate people get. So it's very interesting. I'm excited to see where the plot goes, but let me know if you've watched Squid Games, because probably everybody has by now. And I know You is on Netflix. I've only watched the first season. I don't know if I want to watch the rest, but people are obsessed with the third season, so maybe we'll see. But I have really cute puppies here. Miss Lily is so tired. Just look at this puppy. I'm in my plaid pajama pants, but I also bought some Christmas romance novels from Harlequin's website because they're having buy 3 get 3 free. So I bought 6 Christmas romances for $22. So I'm very excited for that. I want to read all the Christmas romances. I also found 6 on my shelves when I was cleaning through them. And everybody wants me to film an unhaul after I posted my historical romance haul that I got from that estate sale, because I needed like purge some books from my collection that I just don't care about. And I hate filming unhauls. Like, they are so painful to me because I just talk about books I don't like and then I have to edit them. And book hauls already take the longest for me to edit because you're constantly cutting. This is gonna take me forever to edit too. So I don't know if I wanna film a book haul. We'll see if I decide. Let me know if you really want one. I'll do it for you if you really want one, but I never watch them. I don't like that content because it's just like books you don't like. So, but apparently everybody loves them. So if you want it, let me know and I'll see what I can do. But I'm gonna go finish Dorian Gray and then read some Harbor. Hello, everybody. I had to take a little break from this because I had to finish, read half of a book club book for school, reading The Woman in Cabin 10. My kids picked it for our thriller pick for, it was supposed to be October, but the library took so long to get our copies in. So we had to read the first half for Tuesday. So I was reading that all Monday and Tuesday, and I had to read 170 pages of that. But I did jump back into here, and I'm 170 pages into here now, 160, and I'm really enjoying it. I was a little worried because it seemed like everything was going too perfect already, and I don't like when my couples are happy and in love. And so it deals a lot with grief, which is what the second book dealt with, so I'm pretty sure that's the point of this whole series. This is actually book three. The second one, her brother was murdered by a serial killer and he had to help save her, and then months went by and they reconnected and they're recovering together through a physical relationship. And so in this one, it's kind of the same thing, except for their significant others were cheating on them with each other and were murdered. And so she was engaged to him, and Vaughn and Shaw were in a relationship with the girl, a pretty long, I want to say 5 years or something. And so they were both all of them were devastated when not only losing their significant other, but knowing that they were cheating on them too. It really just is hard, a hard pill to swallow. It's hard to be able to grieve, but also grieve the relationship and the betrayal that they experienced. So they decide months later, they're still not able to get over it. So then they meet up, and I was okay, but now it's 150 pages in and we're all good. But then one of them kind of is still having a hard time grappling with what happened and said something they shouldn't have said, and now they're having to make up for that and grovel a little bit, which I like. So it's really interesting. I really like it. I like the dynamic of the relationship, with Vaughn and Shaw already having an established relationship, and then our heroine coming in, Brooke. So it's good so far. I'm excited to see where it goes, because she is not letting them off the hook easily for what had happened. I love her as a character so much, and I'm excited to see where it goes. So it's definitely a really fun read so far. Not fun, but I'm really enjoying the story and the relationship. So I'm gonna hopefully finish tonight. I probably won't. About 100 pages left, and it's already 9 o'clock on Thursday. So I have to get up for work tomorrow, but tomorrow's Friday finally, and it's daylight savings this weekend, which makes me super excited. So I wanna finish this and then jump into The Doctor and read that a lot tomorrow. So we'll see, but I also wanna watch a Christmas movie tomorrow. So I did put up my decorations in my classroom today. I just want it to be Christmas, and so I went ahead and put it up, and the kids were good sports about it. So I just want it to be a happy, fun time, and Christmas makes things happy and fun. So yeah, I'm gonna read this some more tonight and probably go out to Target and Hobby Lobby to get some more Christmas stuff tomorrow, but we'll see. I've already started buying some Christmas presents. I just want it to be Christmas. Hello, everybody. I finally finished Harbor, and I finished that last night, actually, and then was reading The Doctor today, but I ended up really enjoying Harbor. I gave it 4 stars, and it was a lot about, their healing, which I think is a common theme of all three books, even though I've only read books 2 and 3, but I really liked how they talked about their dynamics in their relationship and how it would work with Shaw Vaughn, and the heroine, and I'm forgetting her name. Was it Brooke? I think it was Brooke. And how they would deal with being in a relationship together, and how their families react to it, because the girl that cheated on the two guys, that her family detested them, would not let them even at her funeral. And so how her family would react to it, or people in their lives would react to it. The ending was super sweet, and I enjoyed watching them try to overcome what had happened to them, and messing up with one another and having to make it up to each other. So it was a lot of fun. I really liked it. I really just love Rebecca Weatherspoon's writing and how she writes her characters, and I can't wait to read more by Rebecca Weatherspoon. I had to go back and read book one, but we actually saw the couple from book two, and I don't know if the couple from book one was in here or not, but the couple from book two showed up for a second, and they compared it. She's like, oh well, kind of how we bonded over our trauma, that's what really brings you together. And she's like, oh my gosh, I didn't even think about that. So I really enjoyed this one. So I have 2 4-star books so far, but I started The Doctor today, and it's amazing. It is so much like Birthday Girl, because our heroine has a boyfriend who is pretty deadbeat. He is really annoying. They met 3 years ago and have been dating for 3 years, but now they're in college and he has no priorities. He would rather hang out with his friends. They've just drifted apart. She doesn't like the person he's becoming. He's flunking all of his college classes. He literally just does not care about her. And so she finally breaks up with him, and there's something between her and his dad, And it is so good. He's a doctor. I love how he's so into her too. Like, that's why I love the pool boy. They were so genuinely just into each other, and that's how this one is. Like, they just really, really like each other. It's like sweet taboo romance, which I really, really love. And it's a similar age gap as Birthday Girl. He had his son really young. They had never been married. And so he's not like that much older. It's not like 60 and 20. It's like 40 and 20. Like, I think it said like he is 40. So it's not too taboo, but it's really good so far, and I'm really, really liking it. Like, their attraction is just like undeniable. I love Nikki Sloan's ability to write a taboo romance. Like, I'm just like obsessed with this book so far. So I think it's gonna be 5 stars. Like, The Pool Boy is one of my favorite books of the year. I just loved how smitten Troy was with the heroine, and in this one, the hero is just so into her, and I just love a hero that is just like absolutely 100% smitten with the heroine. So I cannot wait to read more, but I've been planning out some content this week that I'm really excited about. I watched a Hallmark movie yesterday, and I'm gonna have a video on it, which I'm super excited about, and it was so cute, the Hallmark movie, so watch out for that video. I'm like 100% in the mood for Christmas already. So I've been reading some Christmas romances as well, and bought some Christmas decorations yesterday. I went to Target, who didn't really have any Christmas stuff out, and their book selection was so sad. Like, half the shelves were empty and there were no Christmas books on the shelves. So yeah. And then I went to Hobby Lobby and just got like a couple things, but the tinsel I wanted was way out of reach, and I could tell someone tried to get it because they ripped it down and the tag stayed on, so they couldn't buy it. So kind of annoying that was so out of reach, so I couldn't get that. But I did go to my parents' house today for the football game. The house state game was today. It was a close one, but they won, so that was fun. And then I think I'm gonna watch an episode of Squid Game. I started it and it's very interesting, so I might watch another episode today. And then for some reason, I'm super in the mood for puzzles too. When it's Christmas season, I want to do all the Christmas puzzles. So my sister and I got a new puzzle, and then I took some from my parents' house, and so I want to set one up and start it maybe tomorrow. But, and I'm throwing around the idea of doing like Vlogmas / Bookmas. I don't know what it's called, because I know Haley from Haley and Bookland does Bookmas, but like people call it Vlogmas, even though it's just like a video a day in December. If you want that, let me know. If you're like, that's way too much, don't do it. I'm just kind of tempted to do it. I'm just really in the mood for reading romance and talking about it to you guys, so let me know. I also officially put on my Christmas pants. Can you see that? They have dogs. Oh, Lily just heard something. Yep, they are Christmas dogs. They're from Old Navy. Then I have my puppy here. So we're gonna watch some Squid Games while I put the stuff on my Kroger click list. And I know I always say it, but I honestly think I'm gonna finish my book tonight. Like, I'm just gonna stay up and finish it, because it's daylight savings too. So I'm gonna have extra time tomorrow, and it's finally not gonna be dark when I run. It's so dark every morning when I run, and I get so annoyed. I got flashlights to run with. They're like runner flashlights. I think they're called like knuckle lights, where you can hold them like this and it shines straight. I have those now because when I get up at 6:45 and go out my door by 7 o'clock, it's pitch black. It was pitch black my entire run this morning. When I got back at 7:30, it was still dark. So very excited about daylight savings, so it's not super dark when I run now. But that's pretty much my update today, so I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Hello everybody, it is Monday. I just got back from work and I wanted to wrap this up. I didn't have time to wrap it up yesterday. I was so busy yesterday just getting a ton of stuff done. And so I did finish The Doctor. I did not finish it all on Saturday night like I wanted to. I read 100 pages, but I still had the rest to finish. And so I really like this. I'm gonna give it 4 stars. I think I like The Pool Boy better because there was more to the plot of The Pool Boy than there was to this one. In The Pool Boy, there was like a secondary plot with our main characters that was going on, which I loved. And in this one, there really wasn't. I would have loved more with her wanting to be a veterinarian and seeing like more scenes there and her outside life instead of just like her with him in his house. Like, that's really most of the scenes that we saw. I knew that something bad was gonna happen to cause some conflict between them. Like, we were just waiting for that to happen, which I guess like in these kind of books, you know, the conflict's gonna be when the other person figures out about the relationship. And so it, like in The Pool Boy, it was when her best friend was gonna figure it out, and here it was when his son's gonna figure it out. So I don't love knowing for sure what the conflict is, but I still really enjoyed it. I really liked how they were so smitten with each other and really liked each other and were determined to make it work. And the ending was adorable. So 4 stars, a very high 4 stars. I think this is a great series if you like taboo romances, but like I said, The Pool Boy I liked better because I do like that age gap better than this one. But I still really enjoyed this. I appreciated that she was turning 20, so she was a little bit older than what we've seen in some of those kind of taboo romances of this
rebellious nature. So, but I definitely think if you liked Birthday Girl, you would really, really love this one. But like I said, I wanted a little bit more plot outside of the romance, but I really liked their dynamics together and how things developed. And his crazy neighbor was so funny. So definitely like this, definitely recommend it. And that's all I have in this video. I had so much fun reading some of Riley's favorites. All of them were solid 4-star reads. So I would count this as a definite success. Let me know if you read any of these and make sure you go give Riley a follow, check out her channel, and that's all I have. As always, thank you so much for watching and have a good day. Bye.